Hello student, good morning. In this video, we will see another article under unit number 3, that is basic communication operation. So let's start this article. The name of the article is All-to-All Broadcast and Reduction. All-to-All Broadcast is a generalization of one-to-all broadcast in which all P nodes simultaneously initiate a broadcast. A process sends same M word message to every other process, but different process may broadcast different messages. All-to-all broadcast is used in matrix operation, including matrix multiplication and matrix vector multiplication. The dual of all-to-all broadcast is all-to-all reduction, in which every node is the destination of an all-to-one reduction. Now, as shown in this figure, all-to-all broadcast and all-to-all reduction is shown in this figure on this slide. One way to perform an all-to-all broadcast is to perform P one-to-all broadcast, one starting at each node. It is performed naively on some architecture. This approach may take up to P times as long as a one-to-all broadcast. It is possible to use the communication link in the interconnection network more efficiently by performing all P one-to-all broadcast simultaneously, so that all messages traversing the same path at the same time are concentrated into single message whose size is the sum of size of individual messages. Okay, so here all-to-all broadcast, that is a that is a generalization of broadcast in which each processor is the source as well as destination. The process sends same M word message to every other process, but different process may broadcast a different message. All-to-all broadcast and all-to-all reduction is shown here on this slide. So where all-to-all means each process send message to every other process. Okay, all-to-all. And all-to-all reduction means they can receive the message from all other processes. That is all-to-all broadcast and reduction. Okay. Now, all-to-all broadcast and reduction on a ring. Now, in this section, describe all-to-all broadcast on linear array mesh hypercube topology. While performing all-to-all broadcast on linear array, also called as ring, all communication links can be kept busy simultaneously until the operation is complete, because each node always has some information that it can pass along to its neighbor. Each node first send to one of its neighbor the data it needs to broadcast. In subsequent step, it forwards the data received from one of its neighbor to its other neighbor. Now, as shown in this figure, this is the all-to-all broadcast and reduction using a linear array or ring. Now, this figure illustrates all-to-all broadcast for an 8-node ring. The same procedure would also work on linear array with bidirectional links. As with the previous figure, the integer label of an arrow indicates time step during which the message is sent. In all-to-all broadcast, P different messages circulate in P node ensemble. This figure shows each message is identified by its initial source, whose label appears in parentheses along with time step. For instance, the arc label 2 of 7 between nodes 0 and 1 represent the data communicated in time step 2 and that node 0 received from node 7 in preceding step. As shown here in this figure, if communication is performed circularly in the single direction, then each node receives all p minus 1 pieces of information from all other nodes in p minus 1 steps. Okay, now here one algorithm is also given. If you see the algorithm, this gives the procedure for all-to-all broadcast on a p node ring. The initial message to be broadcast is known locally as my underscore message at each node. At the end of the procedure, each node stores the collection of all p messages in result. As the program shows, all-to-all broadcast on mesh applies the linear array procedure twice, once along the rows and once along the columns. In all-to-all reduction, the dual of all-to-all broadcast, each node starts with p message, each one destined to be accumulated at a distinct node. All-to-all reduction can be performed by reversing the direction and sequence of messages. For example, the first communication step for all-to-all reduction on 8 node ring would correspond to last step as shown here in this figure, with node 0 sending message of 1 to 7 instead of receiving it. The only additional step required is upon receiving the message, the node must combine it with local copy of message that has same destination as received message before forwarding the combined message to next node. Now this algorithm of this procedure is shown here for all-to-all reduction. Okay. Now all-to-all broadcast on mesh. Just like one-to-all broadcast, the all-to-all broadcast algorithm for two-dimensional mesh is based on linear array algorithm, treating rows and column of the mesh as linear array. Once again, communication takes place in two phases. In first phase, each row of the mesh perform all-to-all broadcast using procedure for linear array. In this phase, all nodes collect root p message corresponding to root p nodes of their respective rows. Each node consolidates this information into single message of size m root p and proceeds to second communication phase of the algorithm. The second communication phase is column-wise all-to-all broadcast of consolidated messages. By the end of this phase, each node obtains all pieces of m word data that originally resides on different nodes. The distribution of data among nodes of 3x3 mesh at the beginning of the first and the second phase is shown in the figure. So here is the figure of all-to-all broadcast on mesh and the algorithm of this all-to-all broadcast on mesh is also shown here. This gives the procedure for all-to-all broadcast on root p by root p mesh. The mesh procedure for all-to-all reduction is shown here. Okay. Now, as you can see here, the all-to-all broadcast on mesh perform in two phases. In the first phase, each row of the mesh perform an all-to-all broadcast using procedure for linear array. In this phase, all nodes collect root p message corresponding to root p nodes of their respective rows. Each node consolidates this information into single message of size m root p. The second communication phase is column-wise all-to-all broadcast of consolidated messages. This figure shows all-to-all broadcast on 3x3 mesh. The group of nodes communicating with each other in each phase are enclosed by dotted boundaries. By the end of second phase, all nodes get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is, a message from each node. This is the algorithm of all-to-all broadcast on mesh. Now, all-to-all broadcast on Hypercube. The Hypercube algorithm for all-to-all broadcast is an extension of mesh algorithm to log p dimension. The procedure requires log p steps. Communication takes place among the different dimension of p nodes Hypercube in each step. Every step, a pair of nodes exchange their data and double the size of message to be transmitted in the next step by concatenating the received message with their current data. As shown in this figure, all-to-all broadcast on a Hypercube is shown. These steps for 8 nodes Hypercube with bidirectional communication channel. Also, the algorithm is given here for all-to-all broadcast on a Hypercube. This algorithm gives a procedure for implementing all-to-all broadcast on a d-dimensional Hypercube. Communication starts from lowest dimension of Hypercube and then proceeds along successively higher dimension as shown in line number 4. In each iteration, the nodes communicate in pair so that the label of the nodes communicating with each other in the ith iteration differ in the ith least significant bits of their binary representation, that is line number 5. After an iteration communication step, each node concatenates the data it receives during the iteration with its resident as shown in line number 8. This concatenated message is transmitted in the following iteration. As usual, the algorithm for all-to-all reduction can be derived by reversing the order and direction of messages in all-to-all broadcast. Further, instead of concatenating the message, the reduction operation needs to select appropriate subset of buffer to send out the accumulate received message in each direction. This algorithm also explained here procedure for all-to-all reduction. All-to-all reduction is explained here. So, dear students, see, all-to-all broadcast on Hypercube is a generalization of the mesh algorithm to log p dimension. Message size double at each of the log p steps. This is the all-to-all broadcast on 8 node Hypercube explained here. This is the algorithm of all-to-all broadcast on Hypercube on d-dimensional Hypercube. Now, all-to-all reduction. Similar communication patterns to all-to-all broadcast except in the reverse order. On receiving a message, node must combine it with local copy of message that has same destination as the received message before forwarding the combined message to the next neighbor. Now, the cost analysis of this concept or this point is explained here. On the ring, the time given by TS plus TWM P minus 1. On the mesh, the time is given by 2TS root P minus 1 plus TWM P minus 1. On Hypercube, we have T is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to log P TS plus 2 raised to I minus 1 TWM. That is T equal to TS log P plus TWM P minus 1. Now, all-to-all broadcast nodes. All the algorithms presented above are asymptotically optimal in message size. It is not possible to port algorithm for higher dimensional network such as Hypercube into ring because this would cause the contention. So contention for channel when hypercube is mapped onto the ring is shown here. Contention for single channel by multiple messages can be occurred in all-to-all broadcast. All-to-all reduce and prefix sum operation. The communication pattern of all-to-all broadcast can be used to perform some other operation as well. One of these operation is third variation of reduction, in which each node start with buffer of size M, and the final result of the operations are identical buffers of size M on each node that are formed by combining the original P buffers using associative operator. Semantically, this operation often referred to as all reduce operation is identical to performing an all-to-one reduction followed by one-to-all broadcast of the result. This operation is different from all-to-all reduction, in which P simultaneous all-to-one reduction take place, each with a different destination for result. So all reduce and prefix sum operation, in all reduce, each node starts with buffer of size M, and the final results of the operation are identical buffer of size M on each node that form by combining the original P buffer using an associative operator. Identical to all to one reduction followed by one to all broadcast, this formulation is not most efficient. Uses the pattern of all to all broadcast instead. The only difference is that message size does not increase here. Time for this operation is TS plus TWM log P. Different from all-to-all reduction, in which P simultaneous all-to-one reduction take place, each with a different destination for the result. The prefix sum operation gives P number N0, N1, NP minus 1, 1 on each node. The problem is to compute the sum SK equal to summation I to K equal to 0 NI for all K between 0 and P minus 1. Initially, NK resides on node labeled K, and at the end of the procedure, the same node hold SK. So prefix sum operation is shown in this figure, computing the prefix sum on 8 node hypercube. Each node square bracket show the local prefix sum accumulated in result buffer, and parentheses enclose the content of outgoing message buffer for the next step. Okay, so the prefix sum operation, the operation can be implemented using all-to-all broadcast kernel. So we must account for fact that in prefix sum, the node with the label K uses information from only K node subset whose labels are less than or equal to K. This implemented using additional result buffer. The content of incoming message is added to the result buffer only if the message comes from node with smaller label than recipient node. The content of the outgoing message denoted by parentheses in the figure are updated with every incoming message. So dear student, this is the end of this article where we learn the all-to-all broadcast and reduction on linear array, ring, mesh and hypercube. We also discussed the prefix sum operation. So this is the end of this video. Thank you very much.